Welcome back to DL Hughley Uncut. Our final guest is an iconic actress with too many credits to list. Everything from Martin, Everybody Hates Chris. She's currently on the hit CBS show The Neighborhood, which was just picked up for a third season. Say hello to Tichina Arnold.
Hey now.
Hey girl.
Hello.
I feel like every time I see you with Cedric, I feel like you're cheating on Terry Crews. Every time. I feel like it.
Cheating on your actor male part.
That's
I'm working.
Yes, you are. You know, and you work with everybody, and they're all distinctly different people. All of them distinctly different people.
Don't start this interview like we ain't talking.
No, I'm just saying.
Right.
No.
She's like, don't get right into it. What are you doing?
You know what? I had you waiting so long. I didn't want you to think that we were being answers. And I know you're a big star now. So I didn't want to, you know, I didn't want it to be weird.
No. Never consider myself as a star. Stars fall.
Well, you know what? You damn right. Because you won't. You will not stop working. You just show up all the time. What are you? What are you, a cyborg?
Successful.
God damn.
And talented.
I'm a person that enjoys myself. I enjoy what I do. God has always blessed me to continue to do what I do. So here I am, you know?
But to a lot of people, like to the audience in large, who do they most associate you with?
Pam.
Okay. And to me, knowing you as long as I have, she's the most like you to me. The most, like, she's the most like you. Now, I've seen elements of you in all these other roles, but she's the most.
You're right. And the reason why you're right is because originally Pam was written for a heavyset girl. And when I auditioned for it, I was like, yeah, well, guys, I'm not heavy. So, well, whatever. I'm right. Still going for it.
Right.
But when I did Rochelle on Everybody Hates Chris, I was a new mother. So I kind of like took on my mom, my grandmother, and my aunt because my daughter was only 2 years old. So I'm like, okay, I don't know what it means to be a mother of three.
Right.
But, you know, more, you know, I was just like, oh, okay, what am I going to do? But Martin, Pam, yeah, I was a lot like.
No, well, how aren't you like her now?
I'm just, I'm a little more calmer.
Yeah.
As much.
Yeah.
She said as much.
Yeah.
You still might catch them hands, but
I was going to say that, but I was just going to say, yeah, you don't seem to fight as much.
you know, it's like Pam had a baby, you know?
Right.
That's me. Because, you know, motherhood makes you different. Motherhood just kind of brings, you know, your life into perspective, hopefully.
Right.
But life is good. I have no complaints.
You were talking about motherhood and all the changes, because artistically those changes affect you. One of the things I've seen tend to happen is people get stuck in a role, because that was a big role. That was for black people, that was one of those iconic, just chiseled in stone things that happened. It's just always going to be around. It's always it transformed a network, and people felt. It was one of the first times where people who had your experience had ever seen examples of themselves, ever.
That's the perfect breakdown of it.
And so then you became a mother. And then, so usually these people, like, it's like, you know how a space shuttle takes off and then something will drop off and something will drop off. Some people, once they drop off, they stop. Once they but you have not only continued to ascend, but continued to augment yourself. And that's just a weird, that's just not common. At all,
you know, I'm kind of an anomaly in show business from a black female standpoint, because this is all I've done, DL. This is all I've been in show business since I was a child, and it's not all I know, but it's just who I am. It's just a part of me. Entertaining is just who I am, and I try to. Even when I'm not able to get paid to entertain, I find ways to entertain myself.
Right, right.
Either way, I'm going to do
You're going to laugh. You're going to dance. You're going to do something. You know,
I think it's a true testament, though, to just how talented you are as an individual. Because, you know, no, it's true, because I think sometimes it's interesting where, you know, like you said, you do a role and you never overcome that role. And even when you move on, people still see you as that. But for me, every role that you've played, you empty yourself out and you fill yourself back up with that new role. And so for me, you're going to always be Pam. I mean, you're going to be that girl that I wish I could go out with, the one that used to fight all the time, right. So you could fight for me.
Hold my gun.
I consider it as me doing my job right. You know, I consider it as if I do a role and people really, they still call me that role, that means that whatever decisions and choices that I made as an actor, that means I just, you know, I was able to convince them. I was able to pull it off.
Now that you put it off, it's interesting because no, I don't know very many people. When they cast certain roles for a long period of time, they wanted a Pam-like character. That used to be in the breakdowns. They used to say, oh, yeah, for sure. I want a Pam.